I struggled for years to lose weight and failed because I kept trying unsustainable ways to lose it. Once I realized that and I stopped complicating things, I was able to lose 50 pounds in 3 months by following these three easy steps. And I'm gonna cover diet, exercise, and mindset. The first step, I got into a calorie deficit using portion control. So I spent years taking away food groups and all of my favorite foods, thinking that I could only lose weight that way, meaning I took away carbs, I took away treats. I forced myself to eat only weight loss industry, fitness industry approved foods like chicken, broccoli, rice. I ate only clean, organic food. But all that did was make me really dread what I was doing. I didn't like the food and I couldn't stick to it. So I stopped trying to change what I was eating and focused on how much instead. And I started using portion control. I bought a food scale. I bought measuring cups and measuring spoons. And I started using the portions or the serving sizes on the backs of packages like this as a guide for how many portions that I should be eating. And because I was able to enjoy what I was eating, but in portion, I was really able to stick to what I was doing instead of not liking the food. And I know you guys are gonna ask, well, how did you figure out how many portions to eat? So how I did it was I made a portion control meal plan using foods that I really enjoyed, and I would eat that way for a week. At the end of the week, I would weigh myself. If I lost weight, then I would use those portions for the next week. If I didn't, or if I gained weight, I would pull back just slightly on the portion sizes because I didn't want to do too much too fast. It would just end up in me going off track. So go just slightly and repeat it until I found the portion sizes that worked for me. So what I mean by slightly is the serving size here on this box of Cheerios says 1 cup. So I would pull back and go 3/4 of a cup and try that for a week instead and then see how it worked. And I would only do, you know, maybe just make one change and then go from there. And that allowed me to enjoy what I was doing and stick to it. So to sum it up, I did not change what I was eating. I kept eating the same things, but I ate portions instead. I ate my same breakfast, but instead of just eyeballing it or just eating as much as I wanted, I used the serving sizes on the backs of the packages to use guidelines for portions. So again, 1 cup. If that was too much, then I would go to 3/4 of a cup. I wouldn't change anything, everything that I was eating, just a little bit, ate less, but ate foods that I liked. That way, I could stick to what I was doing. So for example, for dinner, Kyle and I, Sassy, my husband, he has lost the same amount of weight as me, and he lost 50 pounds in 3 months too. For dinner, we would eat something like chicken Alfredo, but we would eat 3 plates full. When we were trying to lose weight, we still ate chicken Alfredo, but instead of 3 plates, we tried 2 plates, you know, and seen how that worked. And if we lost weight, then we would stick to that. If not, then we would try 1 plate. And that was how we did it, very simply, so that it wasn't complicated and we still got to enjoy our food. So another thing that we did portion-wise was, like I said, I didn't remove food. I didn't change what I was eating. I loved chips. And I loved pop. I was drinking 7 cans of regular pop a day. And instead of taking away the pop, I didn't want to do that. And I wasn't ready to stop drinking that number of cans. So I just switched to diet pop. And that allowed me to still enjoy it, but I was taking in less calories doing that without even realizing. Also, Sassy and I were eating a bag of chips each a night for a snack. Instead of cutting it out, we went from a bag to a bowl. So we still got to eat our chips, but we were eating less. And all of that, again, allowed us to eat the foods we were always eating and enjoying. We were eating less, and that was what was putting us in the calorie deficit to lose the weight and get the results that we wanted. And so the reason why I was able to lose 50 pounds in 3 months was because I did have a lot of weight to lose, and the portion control helped me stick to what I was doing. I weighed 275 pounds and I am 5'4". So I had a lot of weight to lose, and being able to stick to something consistent like that, just portioning out my food, allowed me, without even exercise yet, to be in a calorie deficit and start getting the results quickly. Then I paired the portion control with step number 2, which was exercise. Exercise, I decided to walk, because at 275 pounds, my weight was making it so difficult for me to do even the most basic daily physical function, like bending down to tie my shoe, getting up and down from a seated position. Everything was so difficult for me. And when I tried different exercises like HIIT, jogging, I tried like all kinds of fitness programs. I bought like the Insanity, the P90X. I wasn't fit enough physically to do those things. And I would either get so exhausted that I wouldn't want to do it again, or I would get injured because physically I wasn't fit. But I could walk. Not a lot, but I could do it. So I decided to commit to walking for 15 minutes every day, rain or shine. And that was something I knew I could accomplish physically. I did have plantar fasciitis really bad in my left foot, and it did make it hard for me to walk. So I decided I would walk at a very slow pace, and I would allow myself as many breaks as I needed to get through the 15 minutes. And at first it did, I stopped about every 3 to 5 minutes. But because I was able to walk at that pace and take breaks, I was able to be consistent with it. And by the end of the 3 months, I had increased my stamina, and I was able to walk for 15 minutes straight by the end without taking breaks. And so, you know, doing the walking combined with the portion control, I'm eating less and eating foods that I loved, and I didn't feel deprived. I was able to stick to the walking, and that allowed me to not just lose the 50 pounds in 3 months, I was able to use these steps to go on and lose a total of 130 pounds and keep it off for 8 years, because I stopped making weight loss a punishment, I stopped complicating it, and I started using these simple, easy things. Hey, I like chicken Alfredo. Don't take it away. Just eat, you know, 2 plates instead of 3. Oh, I can walk a little bit, do that, and do it consistently. And that, combined with the next one, is what really helped me lose the 50 pounds in 3 months. And if you want to know the exact portions and meals that I used to lose the weight, I have my weight loss ebook called The First 50. Link is down below. Code Nicole will save you 10% off. I also got HTLT, or HTLT Sups. These are the Seiko Bar Plus protein bars. They come in Dirty Cookies and Cream and Caramel Toffee Crunch. I love these because they literally taste like chocolate bars, but they have less sugar and more protein, so it helps keep you full and it satisfies all your cravings. Code Nicole will save you 10%. Before I move to the third one, I do get asked all the time in the comments, like, what are the best foods to eat? What exercise? How many steps? Did you count your steps? You know, how many carbs did you eat? How many of this did you eat? If it's complicated and you can't stick to it, it's just gonna set you off track. Can you do what you're doing for a long period of time? If the answer is yes, then keep doing it. If it's too complicated, if, you know, worrying about reaching a certain number of steps is going to throw you off track, which I had emotional eating, so any sort of numbers or tracking or any complication of any sort, it just triggered my emotional eating. If it did that, I would look at it and go, okay, what's a simpler way? What's something I can stick to? I can stick to eating my favorite foods, but just a little bit less, a bowl instead of a bag, 2 plates instead of 3. I can do that. And I can commit to 15 minutes of walking every day for 3 months. Those things were sustainable, and that's why I was able to stick to them. And it's why I've been able to get the weight off and keep it off for so long, because it's sustainable. Number 3 is I had to change my mindset. I had to change the way I looked at and thought about food. What I did my whole life was I labeled food good and bad. And so anytime I would think about or crave or eat anything I labeled as bad, I would feel guilty and I would end up eating way, way more of it. And I would just spiral out of control and it would cause me to gain weight. And then I thought in order to lose weight, I had to deprive or deny myself all of the things that I labeled as bad. And then that would put me in a diet restrict cycle that would end up in all heck breaking loose because it would build and I would eat everything I was denying. And then I would go in a never ending cycle until I got to my heaviest weight of 275 pounds and my weight was causing me serious health problems to the point where my life was at risk. And that's when I had to look at the way I was labeling food. I had to stop labeling food and allow all of it on the table, so to speak. When I started doing that and I stopped denying myself, I said, okay, Nicole, you can eat anything you want on your weight loss journey. It allowed me to choose a balance of foods. And what I started doing was I focused on mostly nutrient-dense stuff. I ate mostly fruits, veggies, protein, healthy fats, and I chose slower digesting carbs for the most part because they helped me feel fuller with all the fiber in them. But included in my balance, in my meal plan, was treats. And I allowed myself treats every day. And when I had lost the 50 pounds in 3 months, and people said, what did you do? And I said, well, I lost 50 pounds in 3 months and I ate ice cream every day. The looks that they gave me was disbelief because they thought the same as me. You had to deprive and deny yourself what you enjoyed to lose weight. It was the opposite for me. I allowed myself a serving of low calorie ice cream, usually ice cream because I loved it, every night after dinner for dessert. And sometimes two like low calorie cookies with it. And because of that, I looked forward to what I was doing. Allowing myself treats and having a balance of food, not cutting anything out, motivated me to wake up and eat my meals every single day. And because I was enjoying my food and I was getting the results, it motivated me to keep walking that 15 minutes every day for those 3 months. And that I was eventually able to build on, like I said, and lose a total of 130 pounds and keep it off for 8 years. It's because I stopped making things complicated. I started choosing things that I could sustain for a long period of time. And that's why I'm standing here right now. You know, I used to weigh 275 pounds. Now I'm 145 pounds, loving my life, loving my food. Physically, I can do all of the things that I couldn't do before when my body was too heavy and not physically fit. And I love myself and I love what I'm doing and I can sustain it. And I know I can do this forever if I want to. And that's why I made this video, in case, and hopefully it inspires anyone out there making their weight loss complicated or making it a punishment to know that it doesn't have to be like that. You should enjoy what you're doing. And my slogan is, if you're not having fun, you're not getting it done, because you're just gonna go off track if you don't love it. So, hope you enjoyed this. Give it a thumbsy up if you did, cuteroonies. Check out this vid, because I always am sharing fun, sustainable weight loss tips, real people in the real world losing weight and loving it, not making it a punishment. Thanks for watching, cuties. I'll catch you in the next vid. Peace it. Oh. Yes. You gotta love it, honey. See ya. Remember the friends that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.